Despite tonight's loss, James Griffin will be on the Right to Life line this November. Channel 2's Rich Kelman joins us live at Griffin headquarters on South Park Avenue to continue our Decision 97 coverage. Rich?
Well, Victoria, Jim Griffin conceded the obvious about 40 minutes ago. He said the numbers coming in showed that he couldn't possibly win under those circumstances. Let's take a look at the tape right now. About 40 minutes ago was the last time we started to see numbers going up on the board by Griffin campaign workers. They first of all posted the South, the Fillmore, and the Lovejoy areas because these are strong Griffin strongholds. By Griffin's own account, this has been what he called a poor people's campaign, a campaign of the old, the infirm, those hit the hardest by the garbage tax. It was a campaign that failed, but not because of his people, he said. And here's what he said.
You know, when I look around this room tonight, if I'm ever in combat and I need somebody to be with me, I'd have to have an awful big foxhole, I'll tell you. You guys and girls have been terrific.
The mayor quoted his Mother Teresa in keeping with his theme of a poor people's campaign. He said, Mother Teresa said, do you know where the poor people live? He said, we do, for sure. Now, Mr. Griffin will still be on the ballot on the Right to Life line come November. The question is, if he loses that, will that be his last hurrah? Will he never run again? I'll talk with the former mayor about that a little bit later in the program. Back to you, Victoria.
All right, thank you. That's Rich Kelman at Griffin headquarters in South Buffalo.
And our other big race.